All right, guys, so I want you to pay attention to this. All right, as you can see, we actually have got. Okay, give me a second. I'm gonna set up the cruise altitude, which is 34,000 feet in there. There we go. So 34,000 feet. So I want to make sure you pay attention to these guys. Okay, as you can see in here, we've got the vertical speed in here, a vertical speed in here, and then as well as we have got another vertical speed on the overhead panel, which is this one. This is another vertical speed. As you can see, it's got 0 in there, 1,000 feet, 2,000 feet, 4 minutes, 3,000, 4,000, and so on. But it's a huge difference. These two vertical speeds that we've got in there are completely different, okay? The vertical speed that you've got in here is the actual vertical speed of your aircraft. So whenever it says, for example, now, 1,600 feet, that means that your aircraft is physically climbing at 1,600 feet per minute, okay? However, this vertical speed in here, guys, is telling us that we are climbing at around 3,400 feet per minute. Okay, so you might ask, okay, what's the difference? The difference is this one. As you can see, it's cabin climb. So that means that this is the vertical speed that the passengers are feeling. Okay, so the cabin inside. Okay, if you were seated in a cabin seat as a passenger, you would feel the rate of climb of this one. So this is 300 feet per minute, 200 feet per minute. So as you can see, it's a lot shallower compared to the physical vertical speed of the aircraft. Okay, if you wonder why, it's because the aircraft is pressurized. Okay, so that's the physical vertical speed, 1,400 feet per minute. However, the passengers and the pilots and the cabin crews are experiencing only 300 feet per minute. So why it is important to monitor this is because if this vertical speed will climb like crazy above 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 feet per minute, that means that the aircraft is not pressurizing, okay? And that's why it's very important that when the aircraft has got a pressurization problem, that you descend below 10,000 feet, which is a safe altitude. And once you are below 10,000 feet, you actually make your descent shallower, okay? You don't descend like crazy, because if you descend like crazy, since the aircraft is no longer pressurized, you will not you will experience as a passenger and as a pilot that rate of descent that the aircraft will produce. Okay, so that's why it's very important, because the aircraft can descend at 3,000, 4,000 feet per minute easily. Okay, and if the aircraft is unpressurized, you use this vertical speed, 3,000, 4,000 feet per minute. That means that you're gonna feel 3,000, 4,000 feet per minute in the cabin, and that's quite a lot. Okay, so now I hope you understand what is the difference between the cabin rate of climb and the actual rate of climb of the aircraft. If you have any question, leave a comment below, and then I will help you out. Also, to pilotclimb.com, where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. I wish you a great day, and I'll see you on the next one.